Welcome everyone. We'll start with another biomolecule. Here in the previous video we have studied about those amino acids. Now in this video we will study about those lipids. Lipids are also biomolecules which are present in the bodies of the living organisms. So here these lipids are the they are water insoluble. These compounds, that is the lipids, they are water insoluble. They are not soluble in water. So lipids are the compounds which are insoluble in water. Lipids are nothing but they can be simple fatty acids. They can be simple fatty acids. They can be glycerol. One form of lipid is a simple fatty acid. Another form of lipid is glycerol. Glycerol is another form of lipid. And in some lipids, both this glycerol and this fatty acids, both of them are esterified. Fatty acid and glycerol, both of them are esterified. They are called as fats. Okay, so lipids are of different types. Here the simple fatty acid is a simple lipid. This fatty acid is consisting of a R group, that is carboxylic group, and it is attached to R group. Lipids are nothing but they can be a simple fatty acid, and fatty acid will have an R group. A fatty acid will have a carboxylic group attached to this R group. The compounds which have an R carboxylic group, those compounds are called as fatty acids. Fatty acids are the compounds in which we find a carboxylic group attached to a R group. A carboxylic group attached to R group. So here what we have seen, these fatty acids are nothing but these are compounds which have carboxylic group attached to R group. This is the carboxylic group, acidic group attached to this R group. Okay, so here this R group can be different. R group is variant. It can be different. So here sometimes, that is, R group can be a methyl group, that is CH3. R group can be a methyl group. For example, we said fatty acids are the compounds which have a carboxylic group and attached to R group. So here this R group can be CH3. This R group can be CH3. So we have this carboxylic group, that is COOH, this carboxylic group attached to R group. If R group can be, I said, CH3. So this is one fatty acid. So here it can be, this R group can be methyl, R group can be ethyl, or it has, that is, more number of hydrocarbons. Actually, ethyl, methyl, these are nothing but hydrocarbons. They are hydrocarbons. So here in methyl we have only one carbon. In ethyl we have two carbons. In ethyl group we have two carbons. So like this we have, that is, number of carbons can be different. Instead of C2 we have C3, C4, C5, C6. It can have carbons up to 19. So we can even have C19 instead of C. See here, if there is nothing, that is not written anything, that means it has one carbon, only one carbon. Okay, so here this carboxylic group can be attached to this one methyl group. Carboxyl group can be attached to methyl group. Methyl group has only one carbon. So here now, if it is attached to ethyl group, we say C2H5COOH. So instead of C2, we can have C19H something. So it will be attached to a carboxylic group. Or C15, some hydrogens, it will be attached to a carboxylic group. So here this is nothing but fatty acid. Fatty acid is a compound where we find this carboxylic group is attached with a R group. R group can be variant. It can be ethyl, it can be methyl, it can be one carbon. It can have two carbons, it can have three carbons, it can have four carbons, it can have CH2 groups which will be consisting of 1 to 19 carbons. It can have CH2 groups which will be having 1 to 19 carbons. That is CH2 group in the sense hydrocarbons. It can have hydrocarbons where the number of carbons, if this is the number of carbons, can be varying. It can be from 1 to 19. It can be from 1 to 19. So these are the fatty acid. It is one type of lipid. In this palmitic acid, we have 16 carbons. I said you the carbons can be from 1 to 19. So here palmitic acid, it is a fatty acid, it consists of 16 carbons. So in the 16 carbon, na, the carbon of carboxylic group is already included. So here, so instead of this COOH, so C15H something will be there. Okay, so this palmitic acid will be having 15 carbons, but in totality how many carbons will be there? 16, because this carbon of carboxylic group is also included. So palmitic acid, it will have 16 carbons including the carbon of carboxylic group. This arachidonic acid, it will be having 19 carbons. C19H. So 19 carbons, and when we include this carbon of carboxylic acid, it will be having 20 carbons. Arachidonic acid has 20 carbons. We said now the carbons can be grouped, that is can have any number of CH2 groups. It can be from 1 to 19. If it is 1, we have seen one carbon attached with this carboxylic acid. So 2 carbons. Here we have 15 carbons. In palmitic acid we have 15 carbons. In arachidonic acid we have 19 carbons. Okay, so in totality palmitic acid will be having 16 carbons, because 15 of this one hydrocarbon chain and one of carboxylic acid. So palmitic acid has 16 carbons, arachidonic acid has 20 carbons in it. So this is fatty acid, one type of lipid. It is one type of lipid where we have a carboxylic group and an R group. So it is one type of fatty acid. Here fatty acids are of two types. That is saturated fatty acids and unsaturated fatty acids. In saturated fatty acids, the carbon and hydrogens will be joined together by single bond only. Whereas in unsaturated fatty acids, we find along with the single bonds, there will be some double bonds also will be there. Double bonds. If there are double bonds in the fatty acid chain, then it is a unsaturated fatty acid. If it has only single bond, then it is a saturated fatty acid. Saturated fatty acids have only single bonds. There won't be any double bonds. Okay, there won't be any double bonds. Whereas in this unsaturated fatty acids, there will be, along with the single bonds, double bonds will also be present. So when double bonds are present, then it will be a unsaturated fatty acid. And because of this presence of this double bonds, now the structure will not be compact. The structure will be somewhat killed. Thoda bahut teda. So here this will have proper structure. You can arrange them like as you like, because they are joined together by only single bonds. So here fatty acids can be saturated fatty acids and unsaturated fatty acids. Saturated fatty acids, they only have single bond. They only have single bond, and unsaturated fatty acids, they have double bonds. Along with single bonds, some double bonds will also be present. So this is one type of lipid. Fatty acid is one type of lipid. Okay, lipids can be made up of fatty acids, or lipids can also be made up of glycerol. This is another type of lipid. Glycerol is another type of lipid. So glycerol is nothing but it is trihydroxypropane. Glycerol is nothing but it is also called as trihydroxypropane. Tri means three carbons. 1, 2, 3. This is the structure of glycerol. So here it is also called as trihydroxypropane. Propane means three carbons. Propane means three carbons. Meth, eth. Meth means one carbon. Eth is two carbon. Prop is three carbons. So propane, three carbons. Ane means only single bonds will be there. So propane, three carbons. And trihydroxy. Tri means three. Hydroxy means OH groups. Three OH groups. 1, 2, 3. Tri is 1, 2. That is single. Single, double, and this is the third. Trihydroxy means OH groups. So three OH groups and this propane. 1, 2, 3. Three carbon containing compound. So it is a propane. So it is glycerol. It is also one type of lipid. It has three carbons attached to this three hydroxy groups. Three carbons attached to this three hydroxy groups. So here these are hydrocarbons. Three hydrocarbon chains are there, and we have these three hydroxy groups. So this is one type of lipid which is called as glycerol. It is called as glycerol. Glycerol will be having three carbons, and here three carbon hydrocarbons and three hydroxy groups. So this is one type of lipid. So here now we have another type of lipid which is a combination of both this fatty acid and glycerol. Another type of lipid is there which is nothing but it is a combination of this fatty acid and glycerol. So here this fatty acids and glycerol, they are combined together to form another type of lipid, and this type of lipid is called as fat. Okay, so this fat is nothing but it is one another type of lipid which is nothing but it is that lipid. This fat is formed by the combination of both fatty acid and glycerol. So here this fatty acids and glycerol are esterified. Fatty acids and glycerol are esterified, and they are called as fats. Fatty acids and glycerol are combined together, and that type of lipid is called as fat. Okay, so now this one, fats, it is another type of lipid which will be consisting of both fatty acid as well as glycerol. It consists of both fatty acids and glycerol. So here this fats they are of three types. Here it is monoglyceride, diglyceride, and triglycerides. These fats are of three types: monoglyceride, diglyceride, and triglyceride. So here we said ke this glycerol CH2OH, then CH2OH. This is the structure of glycerol. This is glycerol. To this glycerol, fats are esterified. Fats are combined with this one. So here a chain of fatty acid. a chain of fatty acid will be attached. If with this glycerol, if only one chain of fatty acid is added, okay, so one glycerol and one fatty acid chain, one glycerol and one fatty acid chain, then that type of fat is called as monoglyceride. Mono means one, monoglyceride. So here in this glycerol plus mono, that is glycerol, glyceride is nothing, glycerol plus mono means one fatty acid chain. So glycerol with this one fatty acid chain, then it is called as monoglyceride. Okay, then this one diglyceride. Di means two. So this is one, another fatty acid chain will be added to it. So this becomes your diglyceride, that is to one molecule of glycerol two fatty acid chains are attached. To one molecule of glycerol two fatty acid chains are attached. So this is called as a diglyceride. And coming to this triglyceride, so tri means three. So to this glycerol three fatty acid chains are attached. Three fatty acid chains are attached. So here if I say this fatty acid, so this is a COOH group and it will be attached to a R group, COOH and R group. So this makes a fatty acid chain. This make a fatty acid. So this is attached to this glycerol. If only one type of chain if only one chain is attached to this glycerol, so one glycerol, one fatty acid, then it is called as monoglyceride. Okay, if to this glycerol two fatty acid chains are attached, okay, so one and another one, two are attached to two fatty acids and one glycerol. If we have two fatty acid chains attached to one glycerol, then it is called as a diglyceride. It is called as a diglyceride. Okay, and if to one molecule of glycerol, if three fatty acid chains are attached, this is one molecule, so three fatty acid chains are attached to this one, then it is called as a triglyceride. Triglyceride. So here glycerol and fatty acids are esterified, combined, then they make the fats. So this is which fat? This is monoglyceride, this is diglyceride, and this is triglyceride. Okay, so in mono we have only one fatty acid chain. In mono we have only one fatty acid, this we don't find. In mono we have only one fatty acid chain. In di it becomes two. In tri three fatty acid chains will be attached to it. So these fats are of three types. Fats are nothing but they are esterified glycerol and fatty acids. They are esterified glycerol and fatty acids. So we have seen lipids in three forms. The first is simple fatty acid, the second is glycerol, and the third is a combination of both fatty acid and glycerol, which is nothing but fats. Okay, so then we also have phospholipids. We also have phospholipids. What are phospholipids? To this fats, along with this glycerol and this fatty acid chain, a phosphate group is also added. A phosphate group is also added. So if a phosphate group is added to a lipid or fat, then it is called as phospholipids. So where do we find this type of phospholipids in our body? They are the components of cell membrane. They are the components of cell membrane. Cell membrane is made up of phospholipids. So along with this one, along with this phosphate group is also attached to it. So that is called as phospholipid. Where we find this phospholipid? It is present in the cell membrane. Example of this phospholipid, lecithin. Lecithin is an example of a phospholipid. So this was all about the lipids. They are water insoluble components. So they can be simple fatty acid which has an in which a carboxylic acid is attached to a R group, or we can have this another lipid, that is glycerol. Glycerol is nothing but trihydroxypropane. So to this propane, three hydroxy groups are attached. Okay, and another type of lipid can be fat, where both this fatty acids and glycerol are combining and forming a lipid, and that lipid is called as fats. Okay, if to this fats can be monoglyceride, diglyceride and triglycerides. Monoglycerides, they have only, that is to one glycerol, one fatty acid chain will be added. Okay, and diglyceride, to a glycerol, two fatty acid chains will be added, and triglyceride is nothing but to a molecule of glycerol, three fatty acid chains are attached. That is nothing but triglyceride. And some, that is fats, will also have phosphate attached to it, and those type are called as phospholipids. Example of phospholipid is lecithin. These phospholipids we find in cell membrane. So this was about the another biomolecule, that is lipid. In the next class we'll deal with, that is proteins, functions of proteins. Basically we will deal with this functions of proteins, but before we go to this functions of proteins, let us see what are the other, that is apart from amino acid, lipids, we also have nucleotides and nucleosides will also be present. So what are those? We will find out in the next video. Then we'll go to the proteins.